Hey guys, how you doing tonight? I've got a project that I'm working on that I need a countdown timer. And it's a video project, obviously. And I just need 3 seconds to go 3, 2, 1. And I'm using iMovie, and I have Motion 5, and I've got Final Cut Pro 10. And everything that I found on the net explained how to do it was so difficult, I wanted to stick a pencil in my eye. But then I was sitting there and I was thinking, well, wait a minute, if I did this, would this work? And I tried it and it worked, and I'm going to share it with you. So here you guys go. A very simple timer, a countdown timer that you may be able to use for something. All right, let's get into it. Okay, so you've got a new motion project, and we're going to make our countdown timer. Now, what I want to make is a 3 second timer, 3, 2, 1. And first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to my little palette, and I'm going to put this on fit. That way I can see exactly what I'm working with. Yeah, that's all I need. Then I'm going to come over here to Edit, come down to Project Properties, and it'll open this here. I'm going to make this a 3 second clip. That works for that. And then I'm going to come over here to Background Color, and I'm going to make that green. And on the background, make that solid. Then I'm going to come over here to text. I'm going to type in a 3, because that's what I'm starting with. I'm going to resize this to, yeah, this is good enough. I'm not going to make these sizes of each number perfect. Right now, about is fine with me, because I'm just doing this for the tutorial. You can, if you want to spend the time measuring these out, that's entirely up to you. I'm just going to do it by feeling. It doesn't matter to me if it's perfect. Sorry, so I've got the 3 over here. I want this to be black, so I'm going to come over here to Style, Colors, choose black, close that, and that is good. So now I've got a 3 second clip of a number 3. But I want that to count down. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to drag this down to the 0000059. You can see it right there in the little thing above my mouse, or above my pointer. It says out 0000059. Go to make it there. The reason I'm making it 5.9 instead of exactly 1 second is because you've got that little fraction of a second between 0 and 1. Okay, next I'm going to come over here. I'm going to, up in this little clock area here, I'm going to click on that to bring this thing over. As you can see, it's 0101. I'm going to take that back to the 1 second mark. If I go to 59, the 3 will be there. Put it at the 1 second mark. Then I'm going to come back over to text. Type in my number 2. I'll go ahead and make that black since I'm over here. Then I'm going to resize it roughly what size of the 3 was. Looks a little bigger. That's okay. Doesn't matter. Now I'm going to do the same thing over here. It starts at 1, and I'm going to take it up to 159. Well, you won't see it here. It'll be in that little banner there. 1, 2, 159. Drop it there. Come up here and click there. Exactly 2 second mark, good enough. Go back to text. Type in my number 1. Change the color to black. Resize it. That one looks a little smaller than that 2 that I just made. Put it in the center. And now I should have a perfect 3 second clip that counts down. I'm going to take, you know, get this back to the beginning and play. 3, 2, 1. Perfect. Okay, now, next thing I need to do is take this over to iMovie or Final Cut Pro or whatever you're using. I'm using iMovie because it's simple. So anyway, I have no idea how to just send this to iMovie, and if anybody does know how to do this, you can tell me. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here to Share and go down to Export Movie and go to Next, and I'm going to title this Timer And I know where this is going because this is a project I've been working on, so I'm just going to save it there. I've already got one in there, so I'm going to replace that with this one. It's very short, so it shouldn't take very long. There you go, the finished product popped up. Now I'm going to close motion. I'm not going to save this because I don't need it. So I've got my iMovie here. And what I'm doing is, I've got this where I want the 3 seconds to pop up, to stop, and then the text come up on the screen. So I've already got these, which these I also made in Motion. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to import a movie. It's already in there. Timer movie. This is the thing I just made. This should import very quickly. It's down here at the bottom. So we've got my timer here. I'm going to select that, and I'm just going to drag it down here over top of the clip, not above it. Okay, over top of the clip, and make sure it's all the way at the end. Release, and green screen. This is why you made the green background. Green screen. And look at that. So now, what I have is... Right. So what I will do is I'll take each one of these down into each one, drop it, green screen it. And when it goes to the next one, 3, 2, 1, orange. All right, guys. Well, that is how you make a very simple timer. In Motion, you can do things with the behaviors. To maybe make these numbers come in, you know, flash in, or, you know, do all kinds of neat stuff. If you come up with something really neat and you want to share it with me, you know, leave a comment here and let me know that you've uploaded something where you use this technique, and I'd love to see it. All right, guys, that is it. Thanks for watching tonight. I'm Mully. Thanks for watching Mully Toots. And if you need anything else, I will give you a call.